Dear students, having understood about the two linear data structures apart from list, stack and queue, now we are going to see about the application of stack. So with respect to application of stack, the major application of stack are found within the computer science field, especially with the compiler design. In that compiler design, the various tasks are expression, converting an expression from one form to another form. That is that we will see in detail in the subsequent slides. Parsing the expression, what is that? Balancing symbol, that is parenthesis checking. These are all the some subtasks of compiler design process. Apart from that, the function calls, this also comes under compiler design. Then you may have a number conversion, that is binary to digital, like that. String traversal, that is reversing a string. Then backtracking, you may find it in a kind of game. So these are all the several applications of stack, especially in the computer science domain. So among these applications, the most important problem that we are going to dealt in this application of stack topic is how to evaluate an arithmetic expression. See, the expression given is an infix form. What is the general format of an infix form? That is operand, operator and operand. Say for example, 5 plus 1, p plus q. See here, p and q are operand. In between the p and q, what is there? Plus. That is operator. A and 5, in between the A and 5, what is there? You have plus. A minus 1 plus 5, like that. Right. So this is a simple example for an infix expression. So how to evaluate an arithmetic expression? Say, for example, if you give 5 plus 1 star 6, so what you will have, what you will do? First, you will do 5 plus 1, that is answer 6, then 6 star 6, that is equal to 36. Or else, what you can do? 5 plus 1 star 6. So what is that? 5. 1 star 6 6. So here, so what is first evaluated? If you look at it, so first this portion is evaluated to give 6, and then this 6 is multiplied to give 36, right? Then 5 plus 1 into 6. Here the 1 star 6 is evaluated first, the 1 star 6 evaluated first, and it is present here. Then this 5 is given here, so 5 plus 6, that is equal to 11, that is equal to 11. So on the whole, what you can infer from is there are two ways. There are two ways of evaluating expressions. Whether two things are correct? No. Among the two, any only one is correct. So in order to evaluate such kind of expression, what you should know is precedence and associativity rule. So this rule is very important in order to evaluate. So what is meant by precedence and associativity rule? There are some order in which you have to give priority to the operator. So if these operators come, that is, it is not operators, if these symbols have come in the while evaluating the expression, this should be given first priority, followed by the operator symbol, then the multiplication symbol, followed by division symbol, then plus symbol and minus symbol. That means the order is first, if you come this symbol should be evaluated first. If that symbol comes first, then this, so like that. So in case if similar priority or a similar precedence is available, then it has to be evaluated from the right to left. That is called associative. In what order you have to say, I have two expressions simultaneously, in what order I have to, whether I have to go right to left or whether I have to go left to right, like that. So that is the situation here. That is the situation here, right? So when you are going to do this 5 plus 1 star 6, so what is that? The priority is star is having major priority, so this has to be evaluated first. 1 star 6 has to be evaluated first. That gives 6. And that gives 6. And see, since now the 5 is alone, so the 5 is coming here. So 5 plus 6 will give 7. So this will be a wrong answer. This is the correct one. So why is it so? Because the star is having higher priority than the plus symbol. Likewise, in case if you have bracket, so what is evaluated first? No, you should not evaluate 1 star 6, having seen that star is having higher priority than plus. But in, apart from plus and star symbol, what is there? Open bracket and close bracket symbol is there. So open bracket and close bracket symbol should be evaluated first. So within the bracket, what is there? 5 plus 1, 6 is there. Then 1 star 6 is 6. So 6 star 6 is equal to 36. So this is correct. this is correct. So likewise, when you are evaluating an expression like this, and you need to follow the precedence and associativity rule. So that's the idea here. So next important thing is prefix notation. So in prefix notation, what is that? It is also otherwise called as Polish notation. You have operator, then operand, then operand. That is, operator should come first. Say for example, if 5 plus 1 is there, the 1 should come in the prefix. So that, what is the answer you got? Plus 5, 1. If A star B plus C is there, then the star should come first. So the, what is the answer you got? Star AB plus C. So in that case, plus C is also there. The plus should brought it in the first time. So plus star ABC, plus star ABC. So if you put a postfix expression, then it is called a reverse Polish notation. What is reverse Polish notation? You have operand first, and you have operand first, and finally you have operator. So 5 plus 1, that is equal to 5 plus 1 plus, that is the plus operator should go in the last. So what do you have? 5, 1, and plus symbol, and plus symbol. So A star P plus C, A plus star P plus C. So what is there here? So A star goes in the forward direction, in the post side, and the plus also comes in the post side. So what do you got? So A B star plus C. So this is the way you have to evaluate the prefix. So in order to evaluate this postfix and prefix expression, no need for associated prefix. So you can easily evaluate. So you have to take those two things. First, you apply this operator, and the result should be added with this by using this operator. So no need to follow this prior, but precedence and associative operators should be followed. So in compiler, in computer, what is the expression that is followed is the prefix and the postfix expression is followed. But when you are going to write any mathematical expression, infix expression is followed. So that is the idea here. So machine can easily read prefix and postfix expression, but a human is more comfortable with the infix expression. So we are very much comfortable. We know only how to read and how to evaluate infix. But the postfix and prefix are very easier for the machine. So what you can do is, when the infix expression is given, the machine has certain code, or the compiler has certain code in it. That code should evaluate, that code should modify the infix to postfix expression, or infix to prefix expression, and then it is evaluated. So this is what the application of, another application of star. So whenever an infix is given, according to the precedence, you will do it. You will do the process. Say for example, so this is the expression given, A plus B star here, which is having the you have to higher precedence star. So B star C, then if you are scanning means, then a plus is there. So the answer, the plus goes by, so you got this expression. Say for example, if you have this this expression, that is this one that is given here, so you got this output based on the scan one and scan two. Two types of scan is there according to the higher precedence. So the postfix expression. So that this is for small expression. Small expression you can use the precedence or other activity. But imagine what about a very big expression like this? If it is a very complicated expression or a very big expression, it requires multiple scan. So how many times you will scan it? So in order to simplify this task, you can go for using this tag. So let me explain the algorithm first. So first, when you read an expression, if that expression, the symbol that is read is an operand, so you have to print as it is. If the stack is empty or contains a left parenthesis, then you have to push the elements in the order in which it is coming. So while pushing the element, if the corresponding closing operator is come, then what is that? You have to take the last, that is pop the element and print the element until the corresponding close by. If the incoming operator has a higher precedence, so you note it down. If the incoming operator has higher precedence than the top of the stack, then what is that? You have to push the element. If the incoming operator has a lower precedence than the top, so what is that? You have to print the top element and pop the stack. Then test the incoming operator with the new top of the stack. So you have to print the top by popping the element, and then you have to test with the another new. So if the equal operator, then you have to follow the associativity. That is, either you have to go for left to right, right to left scan, or left to right scan. The incoming operator has equal precedence with the top of the stack. So at the end of the, so what you have to do is pop and print all the operators of the stack. So that is the idea at the end. So if you are to follow associative rule, you have to follow the left to right, and then print and pop the incoming operator. The associative is then push the incoming operator. So this is the general rule that you have to follow to convert the infix to postfix expression. So remember, so this setup step is always needed, and you should be master these steps in order to solve the problems. That is, in order to convert the very big expression into its corresponding, a very big infix expression into its corresponding postfix expression. So let me explain this with the example. See, if the given expression is this one. So first you scan this. What is the first element? K. So input expression is K. So if you want to convert the expression, you the corresponding postfix is K, because only one symbol is there. The K is there. The K is printed. Now next you use plus symbol is there. So plus symbol is there. So inside the stack plus is one, because the rule says that if it is a symbol, you push the symbol. L, then you have to place the L here. So plus is already there. Minus. Now from the over the plus, minus is going to come. So already plus is there for the plus. So what is the rule says? If the incoming operator has a row here present, then print the top by popping the stack, right? So you have to take the plus and print it. Now what is the another one? M is taken. Now what is the star? So star is that if it is a higher preent, if the is higher, push it into the stack. So since the star is higher than minus, it is pushed into the stack. What is the, again the symbol read N? So N is printed in the next to M and N. Then what is the symbol that is printed? Plus. So if it is plus, what do you have to do? Plus should overcome the minus star operator. So what do you have to do? So since it is having the plus is having a lower priority, so you have to take out the plus, and then you have to take out the minus also. So you have to plus the plus next. So what next? What is that? The open bracket and the closing bracket is there. So you have to push the close open bracket and accordingly read other operators power symbol. So then pop the element, print O, and then push the stack in. And then the expression, if you find out the star power symbol is there, so P is red, so P is printed. And the corresponding closing bracket is there. If the corresponding closing bracket is out, you have to pop up the element until that corresponding left parenthesis. So the closing symbol is there. So what is then read? So that is read as star symbol. So star symbol is put, so plus the star. So what is that? So plus star is there, so no need to pop up that. W is there, so W has been taken out. Now the plus symbol is star. So since it is have say similar property, you have to do the according to the property right to left associativity. So you have to take out the element and then you have to print. Now the plus star symbol plus slash symbol. So U is there, U is printing out. Next again the red symbol is slash. Already some slash is there, so you have to take out the slash and then you have to print the stack. Push it on the stack, right? So then V is coming, V is printed. Then star is coming. So star is coming. Then what is that? You have to print and pop up the star symbol and then push the star into the stack. So T is coming. So T is printed. Then plus the star coming free is T is printed. T is printed. The plus is coming. So already star is there. So star is printed. Then plus is printed. So Q is coming. So Q you have to print it here. So finally the plus is there. That plus is also final element. So you have to pop this. So this is the step. So how these steps are possible? These steps are possible by reading this step. By reading this step, according to the step, you have to apply each and every step meticulously without any. So you have to think about while you are picking an element what it is exactly, so how to do it. So accordingly you have to do the idea, and accordingly you have to push the element or you have to pop the element and print the element. So in general what you can do is, in if it is an operand, you print it. If it is an operator, you push it. If the operator is having higher precedence, then you have to push it. If the operator is having lower precedence, then you have to pop it. If the operator has an equal precedence, then you have to use the associative rule. So associative rule may be either from left to right or from right to right according to the operator that is discussed here. That is discussed here. So according to the thing. So what is whether you have to go to left to right or not? So here it is given left to right or right. Left to right. So that is the idea here. Right. So what is this? This is another example. What is if it is having the equal thing? So Q is red. Since it is an alphabet, Q is printed. So the next symbol read is power symbol. So power symbol is there. So the power symbol is pushed into the stack. Then what is the J is there? What you have to do? Print the J. Then what is the power symbol is there? Power symbol is red. So what is that? You have to push it onto the stack. So then what is there? A symbol is there. A is, it is printed A. So you have to pop and print the first priority operand and second priority. So it, since it is the equal priority, so you have to evaluate the left to right expressions, priority associative rule. So this is the corresponding postfix form. So likewise, if you apply this rule, so you can find the solution for these exercises. You try it on your own for solving this exercise. And in the Google Classroom, the corresponding PowerPoint presentation is also available, and you can find the solution to all these 7 problems. So what you have to do is, for solving all these 7 problems, you see this rule and you apply the each and every step of the rule by maintaining the tabular method like that, and accordingly you solve the problem, right? So in case if you have any doubt, you can refer the Google Classroom material and you can find the answer. So the slides are like this. See, for every problem, what is the expression? So the slides are like this. So it is easier for you to understand the thing, right? So this is the program to convert the infix to postfix expression. See, the when you see, this is the statement for header file inclusion. Here the stack is initialized. Here the code for push operation. Here the code for pop operation. And here this for priority checking. Code for priority checking. So if x is close open bracket, or if it is a plus or minus, or if it is star or divide symbol, so what is the priority value it is. So main expression. So expression is the red. So in the character array. So by using the scanf statement, the expression is red. Then with the while loop, until the expression is not null, all the operator is taken out. So according to the priority rule, so every time the priority is called, right? So you have to either push or pop the element and it is printed. So why it is according to the priority, So finally, if you anything, any element is left, then you have to pop all the elements and then you print the element. So this is the simple program, which doesn't address all the situations or all the cases, but reasonably for most of the situation. So this program is very easier for you to understand, as well as the code for converting the given infix expression to postfix expression. So the block is header file inclusion. So let me explain again. The block is So the block is header file inclusion, character array initialization, code for push operation, code for pop operation, code for priority checking, main function, inside that initialization of the expression, in the E expression is there, and then in the while loop, each and every symbol of the expression is red. So if the expression is alphabet or is the operand, accordingly you have to take a decision. If the operator is, if the expression, the symbol that read is symbol, so accordingly you have to do the process, whether it is open bracket or closing bracket or plus symbol or minus symbol, accordingly you have to either open or close the thing. So then what do you have to do finally after doing the thing, if anything is left as a residue, so what do you have to do finally? You have to pop and print all the elements. That is the idea here. So evaluating arithmetic expression. So what is this expression is saying? See here, not only the expression is given, in addition to the expression, what is given? Some A, B and some C. So these values are being given. So you have to substitute the value. So in A, you have to see, this is A, B. So what is that? So A, B, 1, 2 is there. What is the symbol? Plus is there. So you have to take out. So whenever a symbol is there, you have to take out the element from the stack and then add it. So the result is 3. So now what is the element? Another is C. What is in the C? 3. So 3 is put. What is the symbol? Minus symbol. So whenever minus symbol, you have to take out and the 0 is put. Then what is the other value? B. For B, what is the value? You have to put 2, right? And then the B, then A is 1. So you have to put 1 here. And another symbol is plus. So when you plus comes, you take off the next 2 element and then add the element and 3 is coming, right? Next, what is that C? What is C? 3. So 3 is pushed. So now you have 0, 3, 3. The next symbol is power symbol. So you have to take the 3, 3. So 3 power 3. So what do you have got? 27. Now 0, 27 is there. Next symbol is minus. So 0 minus 27, the result is minus 27. So accordingly. So what is the rule here is, whenever you have, see, first of all, you have to substitute the 1, 2, 3 here. So what is AB? 1, 2, plus, then 3, then minus, then 2, then 1, then plus, like that. So like that it goes on. So this is evaluating the arithmetic expression. 1, 2, 3, minus. So accordingly, you have to do the activity. for evaluating the answer. That is the final answer. So likewise, you have the problems, you solve all these problems with the rule that I just illustrated. So in case if you face any difficulty, you can refer the PowerPoint slide that is in the Google Classroom, that you can find it very well. So I see the answer for every step and operations is given. So how to solve that problem and how to find the solution to the problem, right? So this is the way in which we have understood the application of stack. So what are the application of stack we have seen so far? So the way we have find the majority of applications for the stack with respect to computer science, especially the compiler design, as well as the some kind of application like number conversion, backtracking, string traversal, like that, right? So other things are expression conversion, syntax parsing, parenthesis checking, balancing symbol. So these are all the applications, these are all the tasks with respect to designing a compiler, right? So first we have seen about evaluating arithmetic expression, then infix to postfix conversion, then we have seen about a program to convert the infix to postfix expression, and finally we have seen about how to evaluate the arithmetic expression. That is the first one. So when it is a simple expression, it is easier to follow, convert, or in which is easier to solve. When it is a complicated expression, so what you have to do is you should seek the help of the stack. So with this few information, let us find up the topic of application of stack. So further clarification, you can refer the material in the Google Classroom, right? So thank you.